Okay, now we move to the exercise 2.2. Same bit again. Find the value of the polynomial 4x square minus 5x plus 3. At here some problems are there. Four or five problems are there. In this I am taking first one and fourth one. In the second bit also, we given for p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, we have to find the for all the polynomials. Here also 4 to 5 problems are there. Here I am taking first one and fourth one. Remaining we have to solve the problems. So now given here it is in variable x, no? So we write given p of x is equal to 4x square minus 5x plus 3. First one, x is equal to 0. So substitute one place of x, we are substituting 0. 4 into 0 square minus 5 into 0 plus 3. Here 0 square is 0. 0 into 4, 0. 5 into 0, 0 plus 3. So here 0 minus 0, 0, 0 plus 3. Here p of 0 value is what? 3. So 3 is the value of the polynomial. 3 is the value of the given polynomial at x is equal to 0. And fourth one here x is equal to 1 by 2. So given polynomial is what here? P of x is equal to 4x square minus 5x plus 3. From this first bit, this polynomial you should take for different values. So fourth bit x is equal to 1. So which implies p of 1 by 2 is equal to 4 into 1 by 2 square, 5 into 1 by 2 plus 3. That is equal to 4 into 1 by 2 square is 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4. Minus 5 into 1, 5, 5 by 2 plus 3. So now 4 gets cancelled. So 1 plus 3, 4. That is equal to here 1. 4 gets cancelled. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 minus 5 by 2. That is equal to LCM is what? 2. Here nothing denominator means 2 into 4, 8. Minus 5, because same denominator LCM, minus 5 is equal to 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 is the value of the polynomial when x is equal to 1 by 2. Coming for the second bit, p of 0 we have to find, p of 1, p of 2 for the given polynomials. P of 0, p of 1, p of 2 for the first problem, and fourth problem also p of 0, p of 1, p of 2 for this fourth problem also. For all problems, 4 to 5 problems are there. For all problems, you have to find 3 values. So for this first one, p of x is equal to x square plus 1. First, we will find p of 0. P of 0 is equal to 0 square. In place of x, what we have to substitute here? 0. 0 square plus 1. That is equal to 0 square is 0. 0 plus 1, 1. Next one, what? P of 1. So now, p of 1 is equal to, in place of x, we have to substitute 1. 1 square. 1 square plus 1. 1 square is what? 1. 1 plus 1, 2. And one more, p of 2. So p of 2 is equal to, for the same problem, 2 square. In place of x, what we are substituting? 2 here. 2 square plus 1. 2 square is 4. 4 plus 1, 5. This is about what? The first problem. Now we'll go for the fourth problem. What is fourth problem here? P of t is equal to t plus 1. So here also you have to find p of 0, p of 1, p of 2. P of 0, p of 1, p of 2 we have to find. So now p of 0. That is equal to 0, t in place of t, 0 you have to substitute, 0 minus 1 into 0 plus 1, 0 minus 1 into 0 plus 1, that is equal to 0 minus 1, minus 1, 0 plus 1, 1, minus 1 into 1, minus 1. Next p of 1 we have to substitute, that is in place of t, 1 minus 1 into 1 plus 1, that is equal to 1 minus 1, 0, 0 into 1 plus 1, 2. 0 into 2, 0. And one more value, p of 2. So p of 2 is equal to, in place of t, 2. 2 minus 1 into 2 plus 1. So for all p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, in t minus 1 into t plus 1. This is the given polynomial. In this, you have to substitute t value as 0 once time, 1 time and 2 1 time. Because we have to find p of 0, p of 1, p of 2. So p of 0 we got minus 1, p of 1 we got 0. And now we are finding p of 2 in place of t. 2 minus 1 into t plus 1 means 2 plus 1, that is equal to 2 minus 1, 1, 2 plus 1, 3, that is equal to 1 into 3, 3. So p of 0 value is minus 1, p of 1 value is 0, p of 2 value is 3 is the value of the given polynomials. So children, now we will go for the third bit. Verify whether the values of x given in each case are the zeros of the polynomial or not. Zeros of the polynomial is what? In place of x, if we substitute the given value, if the value becomes 0, then we can say that the substituted value is the 0 of the polynomial. Now p of x is 2x plus 1. In place of x, we substitute minus 1 by 2. If we get the 0, zero, then we can say minus 1 by 2 is the zero of the polynomial. Yes, we can say. And here also, f of x is equal to 3x square minus 1. Here x square is 2 values are given. Now first I will substitute in place of x minus 1 by root 3. If the value is equal to 0, then we can say minus 1 by root 3 is the zero of the polynomial. Next we'll substitute 2 by root 3. If the value is not 0, then we can say that 2 by root 3 is not the zero of the polynomial. Overall, after substituting if the value is 0, then we can say that the given value is the zero of the polynomial. Or after substituting if we not get the 0, then we can say that it is not the zero of a polynomial. Let us take first one. So here 8 or 9 problems are there. I am taking only 2 problems. Rest of the problems you have to solve. So if p of x is equal to 2x plus 1, x is equal to minus 1 by 2. So in place of x, we are substituting minus 1 by 2. P of minus 1 by 2 is equal to 2 into, in place of x we have to substitute here 2 as it is, x means what, minus 1 by 2 plus 1. So 2 gets cancelled, minus 1 left here, plus 1. So minus 1 plus 1 gets cancelled, what you get here, 0. So here P of minus 1 by 2 is equal to 0. So we can say that the given value minus 1 by 2 is the, short, I am writing ZOP. ZOP means what? 0 of the given polynomial. Because the value is 0, after substituting in place of x minus 1 by 1 by 2, we got the value 0. That's why the given value at x is equal to minus 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2 is the 0 of the polynomial because the value becomes 0. Let us go for the 7th one here. F of x is equal to 3x square minus 1. First, we are given 2 values. Let us take first value. X is equal to minus 1 by root 3. So F of minus 1 by root 3 is equal to 3 into in place of x minus 1 by root 3 whole square minus 1. 3 into minus 1 square means plus 1. Because minus 1 to the even number means it become positive. So 1 square is what? 1 minus 2 power of even number positive. So square and root eliminates here, but both numerator and denominator you have to square it here. 3 as is minus 1 square is 1. Root 3 square. Square and root eliminates what you get here? 3 minus 1. So 3 gets cancelled here. 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So what you can say here? Here f of minus 1 by root 3 is equal to 0. So minus 1 by root 3 is the 0 of a given polynomial. Let us take one more value here. X is equal to second value 2 by root 3. 2 by root 3. So f of 2 by root 3 is equal to, in place of here 3 into, I am not writing here, I am taking directly here, 3 into x square. X means what here? 2 by root 3. 2 by root 3 square minus 1, that is equal to 3 into 2 square is what? 4. Square root eliminates 3 minus 1. 3 gets cancelled. 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Here the value is not equal to 0. So here f of 2 by root 3 is not equal to 0 because here we got here 3. So 2 by root 3 is not 0 of a polynomial. Why because here f of 2 by root 3 is value is what? 3. So here f of 2 by root 3 is not equal to 0. So 2 by root 3 is not the 0 of a given polynomial. But here when we substitute x value minus 1 by root 3, we got here 0. So 1 minus 1 by root 3 is the 0 of the polynomial. But when we substitute it here, so let's pause. Okay, here minus 2, if we substitute minus 2, here 2 by root 3, here the value is not equal to 0 because the value is 3. So f of 2 by 3 is not equal to 0. So 2 by root 3 is not the 0 of the, okay, so 0 of the is not the 0 of the polynomial. Okay, now fourth bit, find the 0 of the polynomial in each case. So find the 0 here, they did not give any value here. So in this case, what we have to do, when the value of the variable is not met, we have to equate the given value to 0 and then we can find the value of the variable, 0 of the variable by finding the value of the variable, that is x. Here also we have to equate to 0 to find the 0 of the polynomial. So whenever the value of the variable is not given, for the given polynomial we have to equate to 0. Let f of x is equal to 0. To find the 0 of the polynomial, we have to equate the given polynomial to 0, which implies f of x is what here? 2x minus 3 is equal to 0, which implies 2x is equal to minus 3 transforms to plus 3. Right, when it transforms to right side, it becomes positive. So x is equal to 3 by 2 transforms to the right side, comes to the denominator. X is equal to 3 by 2. So therefore, 3 by 2 is the 0 of the given polynomial. What is the meaning of this one? 3 by 2 is the 0 of the polynomial. In place of x, if we substitute the 3 by by 2. Let us substitute here. 2 into in place of x 3 by 2 substitute 3 by 2 minus 3. 2 2 gets cancelled. 3 minus 3 is 0. That's why we'll get 0. When we substitute x value 3 by 2, we get the 0 of the polynomial. Here also equal to 0. Let f of x is equal to p of px plus q. Px plus q, x is the variable. Let f of x is equal to 0. To find the 0 of the polynomial, let f of x is equal to 0, which implies what is f of x value here? Px plus q is equal to 0. We have to find the value of x. Px is equal to plus q plus of 2 minus q. Then x is equal to minus q by comes to the denominator p. Therefore, minus q by p is the 0 of the given polynomial. 0 of the given polynomial. Close it.